Name three groups of plants that bear archegonia. Briefly describe the life cycle of any one of them. So archegonia is a female reproductive organ that produces female gamete, or it is also called as egg. Now these archegonium are present in bryophytes, pteridophytes and gymnosperms. So here we can see a fern, a prothallus of a fern, which contains the reproductive organ. So these are archegonium and this is anthridium. So archegonium is the female reproductive organ. They produces the female gamete, which is called egg. Now this kind of structure, archegonium, is found in bryophytes, pteridophytes and gymnosperm. Fern is a plant which belongs to division pteridophyte. Now let us learn the life cycle of a fern. So in a life cycle of a fern, the main plant body is sporophytic in nature. So that means, so let us start from here. The main plant body is sporophytic in nature. So all sporophytes, they have diploid number of cells. So here the number of cells will be 2n. And we can see the leaves and the brown structures present on the lower surface of the leaf. These leaves are called sporophyll, and the brown structures present on them are called sporangium, and the sporangium produces spores. So since they produce spore, the leaf is called sporophyll. So in ferns, the main plant body is sporophytic, and the mature leaves on its lower surface, they have sporangium. So even the leaves are also diploid in nature. The sporangium is also diploid in nature. And inside the sporangium, meiosis takes place and produces haploid spores. So here we can see these are the spores. They are haploid in nature. So from diploid, the chromosome number is reduced to half. That is haploid. So this division is called meiosis. So a plant body which is diploid in nature, it is giving rise to spores which is haploid. When these spores develop or germinate, it gives rise to a plant which is gametophytic. That means which have got half number of chromosomes. Because spores have haploid number of chromosomes, and the plant which forms from the spore, that will also have half number of chromosomes. So it is haploid in nature. And now this plant in the initial stage, it is heart-shaped and it is called prothallus. So spores on germination give rise to a structure which is heart-shaped. This structure is called prothallus. Since it contains n number of chromosomes, that is haploid number of chromosomes, they are called gametophyte. So a diploid plant body is giving rise to a haploid plant body. And as this prothallus develops, it will have structures anthridium and archegonium. Now these structures are haploid in nature and they produces gametes which are haploid in nature. So anthridium produces the sperms and archegonium produces the egg. So these structures are present in the reproductive organs. Anthridium and archegonium are present on the prothallus. This is also haploid in nature. So they also produce gametes which are haploid in nature. Once these gametes fuses, a zygote is formed. So when two haploid cells fuses, the cell become diploid in nature. So the chromosome number has increased after fertilization, and the zygote develops into a plant body which is diploid. Since the cell has got two sets of chromosomes, it develops into a plant body where each cell will have two set of chromosomes. So initially we learned a sporophytic plant body gave rise to gametophytic plant body. Now we can see here a gametophytic plant body is giving rise to a sporophytic plant body. So like this, in every generation, one generation will be diploid in nature and the other generation will be haploid in nature. This kind of life cycle is called alternation of generation. So the zygote which forms develops into a new sporophyte, and this sporophyte contains sporangium and it produces spores. So this repeats. So this is the life cycle of a fern. So it starts with the diploid plant body. Here the sporophyte is the major plant body, it is the dominating phase, and this gametophyte will be short-lived. So we can say the major phase will be mature sporophyte. So it starts with sporophytes, it produces spores, spores develops into a gametophyte. Gametophyte have got anthridium and archegonium, they produce spores, spores fuses to develop into a zygote which will be diploid. Zygote develops into a plant body which will be sporophyte. So this kind of life cycle we can see in ferns.